The Lord be with you. On behalf of the community at First Presbyterian Church and our organist of 30 years and counting, I welcome you to this celebration of the gift of music, of the gift of this organ that just keeps on giving, thanks to God's help and your support. And we also are gathering today to celebrate with Rebecca Tiveldi, 30 years as our organist here at First Presbyterian Church. Some of you may be very familiar with this organ, but for those of you who are not, just a few things to point out to you. There is a full history of our organ. It is a Reuter organ that was built in 1955, an organ 1125, dedicated in 1956. The organ history is available at stillwaterfpc.org, stillwaterfirstpresbyterianchurch.org. Renovations and enlargements occurred in 1996, also in 2009, and we are all breathing a sigh of relief that the renovation work done this year in 2021 has been completed. It was done by the Reuter Company at the factory in Lawrence and also here on site in the organ chamber. We have brand new keyboards, which I don't think any of us appreciate unless you've been pressing on those keyboards for a couple decades. Refurbished pedals, brand new trumpet pipes, and cleaned oboe pipes, plus mechanical maintenance. Thank you to those of you who over the past 12 years have given gifts to our dedicated organ repair fund, our dedicated music funds, including the Sherrar Organ Endowment, the McCullers Art and Beauty Endowment, and the Joy Smith Music Endowment. All of your donations this evening will go into that Joy Smith Music Endowment, which makes this series, which is just one recital in a series that we have called Soli Deo Gloria, to the glory of God, possible throughout the year. Finally, we want to thank the Allein Reif Brown Foundation for a substantial and timely gift that helped facilitate our 2021 renovation. And we thank J.R. Newtel and the Reuter staff for their impeccable work, and to John Deal and Sean, who were some of his assistants on site for this renovation. They also came last Friday to tune, and we thank them for that as well. They keep us in good working order. We are so pleased to have this organ recital put together by Rebecca Tiveldi. If you've taken a look at your program, you will notice there is something old and something new in this program. It is a delightful mix of works. Rebecca Tiveldi first started playing here at First Presbyterian Church in Stillwater on September 1st, 1991, succeeding Linda Hack as organist, and has worked with six choir directors before succeeding Heather Lanners as our director of music in 2014. So she wears at least two hats here at First Presbyterian Church. We are thankful to be gathered again for the gift of music, for the gift of life together, and for the gift that it is to celebrate with Rebecca Tiveldi this evening.
I know you came to hear music, but I have to say a few words. And I was supposed to turn this thing on also. First of all, thank you for being here. My heart is overwhelmed with gratitude for the blessing it is to play and make music with the people of this congregation and in this community. And you're all friends, you're family. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart from all of your support all of these many years. And I'm not near done. I need to make a special thank you to my pastor, Leah. I have had the privilege of collaborating with her over 14 years when she first came to this congregation. Such a joy and blessing to get to minister under her direction and the staff of this church. I cannot tell you, to a person, unbelievable, talented. I can't do what I do without each one of them and the grace that they offer me continually is such a blessing. I can't tell you enough. I want to also thank the congregation for giving me a sabbatical leave this past summer, which helped me recharge batteries that were a little worn down in the wake of COVID and everything. And it was a great blessing to be able to not watch the clock quite so much for several months and really dive into projects. So I'm incredibly grateful for that. Also, my choir family. It has been such a joy. I never dreamed that I would get to direct them. And it's such a privilege. They are wonderful people, and they make beautiful music, and every Sunday morning is exciting and rich in music making. And Wednesday nights, by the time I get to Wednesday night, I'm wondering how I'm going to get through rehearsal. And by the time we come out of rehearsal, I have quadruple the energy I had going in. Just amazing. I want to also thank my AGO colleagues, American Guild of Organists. Dear friends, some of you have traveled in today, and I appreciate your presence very much and your support also over these years. The organist can only sound as good as the organ is. And we also can't just run up and tune really quickly if there's a rogue note. So first of all, I want to thank John Deal and Sean Estenek from the Reuter Company, who came down on Friday and put it into really glorious condition. It's been through a heat wave, and then some cold, and then some more heat. so it's sounding absolutely wonderful, and I'm very grateful to them and to the Reuter Company for the work that they've done. It happens that Sean, who was one that came to tune on Friday, is the one who voiced our new trumpet stop at the factory. And this was his first time to come to our church. He really enjoyed it. And I made him autograph one of his pipes with a Sharpie. So over the years, this organ had really beautiful care by William Stevens, who was the technician when I came in 91. He had been caring for the organ for quite a long time. I don't know when he started. He also was affiliated with the Reuter Company, although working independently. And he was succeeded by Roger Banks, same situation, independent, but affiliated with Reuter. So Reuter has had its fingers on this instrument from day one. And we're incredibly grateful to them. It's a thriving company. If you ever get to Lawrence, Kansas, find the Reuter factory and, email them ahead of time and tell them you want a tour. Incredible place. It's like 20,000 square feet. It's ridiculous. Okay, thank you for being here. Now, in the piece that I just played, that middle section had a nice bitey reed sound, and that is the new trumpet up in the swell division. Now, in this next piece, you're going to hear that rank, new pipes, in the melody. That's going to play the melody line in this next piece, which is a chorale prelude. It's a hymn setting of a German hymn tune that was sung pretty much every week as the Gloria in Excelsis, glory be to God on high. And it's only in two parts. The left-hand part reminds me a lot of Bach's cello sonatas and things, very much string playing kind of sound, jumping around a lot. And then that'll be followed by the Bach Prelude and Fugue in C major, which is one of the late works of Bach. Very complex, but incredibly joyful. The prelude has a bit of an epiphany connotation because Bach uses a theme that he used in his Epiphany cantata. Epiphany is the celebration of the wise men, the three kings reaching the manger to worship the baby Jesus. And this work is not programmatic in any way, but I wonder if Bach just liked that theme so much that he decided to explore it some more and made this big piece, the prelude, out of it. And then the fugue has a very short theme subject, and it repeats more in the fugue than I think any other fugue subject that Bach ever wrote. And it overlaps itself, so you'll hear it almost all the time, all the way through that fugue, in the texture. And you'll know when the pedal finally gets that theme. So I hope you enjoy these Bach pieces. Thank you. now it's your turn to do some singing. So you have Glory to God hymnals in your pews, and the program tells you your numbers and your verses to sing. We won't be singing all the stanzas, except of the first one. We will sing all the stanzas of Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. And I'm going to play pieces based on these tunes. So the very first one is a very happy, joyful setting by Michael Burkhardt. The second one, Our God, Our Help in Ages Past, this piece is aria style, in other words, like a song without words, melody, on a ground, which means the bass line is a ground bass. It keeps repeating as the piece goes along. And I just want to say that one is dedicated to Dr. Gerald Frank. And I don't have my right glasses on, so I can't see. Okay. And I want to thank Jerry for being a friend and such a wonderful colleague these many years. I enjoyed thoroughly a year of studying with him and learned an awful lot in that year. So thank you, Jerry. And then the third one, Now Thank We All Our God. First, a setting, really trippy little setting by my friend David Schelat up in Delaware. And then we sing it, and then you're going to hear a piece by Michael Bedford, who is here today. And I do see him up in the front row from Tulsa. So I hope you enjoy these pieces. The Bedford piece, is that the one? Starts out, I'm using the trumpet stop a lot in these hymns. I'll just say that. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Okay, I need to tell you a couple things about the next three pieces. A Highland Procession was written by my father for my sister's wedding. It's the only time I was a bridesmaid. And we were, both she and I were married at First Presbyterian Church in Seattle, Washington, which has a really long nave, very long aisle. But we both had very small weddings. We were each other's attendant, and that was it. So we sent the minister down first, and then we sent the best man down the aisle, one at a time, so that it was a longer procession. So my brother-in-law, Mike Lyles, has Scottish heritage, and so this is called a Highland processional. It has a bit of a Scotch snap to it, a catchy rhythm that's part of that. And that instrument at First Pres Seattle had a big trumpet in the very back of the church, and so he started the fanfare on that, kind of blew people away at the beginning, and then launched into the march. It has a lot of the qualities of Elgar's pomp and circumstance marches. I think you'll hear that spirit. And then we're going to follow that with some Elgar, with the Elegy. This is the transcription of the Nimrod variation from the Enigma variations. And I think you will recognize that beautiful melody. And in that piece, I'll use some of the very softest sounds on the organ. And then we will launch into the Mendelssohn Sonata, number 4 in F, or B flat major, sorry. Mendelssohn was commissioned by an English publisher to write voluntaries, some voluntaries, a set. And that's sort of a nebulous term even now. Voluntary is just typically, we think of something that the organist plays for church, prelude, postlude, offertory, whatever, voluntary. Mendelssohn had no idea what that meant. So he just started writing pieces. And then he grouped them together and he called them sonatas. So in this instance, we have 4 really fantastic pieces that make up the sonata number 4. So thank you again for being here, and I'm grateful to every one of you for sharing this time.
not an adequate summary of that, except our deep, deep thanks. And Soli Deo Gloria. I'll be brief, but I have a small token of our appreciation. Becky, if you'd join me here in front of the chancel. We know you've been working night and day, so we hope that you have a chance to rest, relax, and rejoice in the joy of all that you have done for us these first 30 years. But we thank you. And this is handmade by a church member, James Cosley, designed for you and etched. And thanks to all of you for being here in person. It is truly a joy to give thanks to God together, to share in the music, and as you said, the singing and rejoicing together.